The Nord Stream pipeline, running through the Baltic Sea, is currently the biggest infrastructure project in the Baltic region. Over a length of more than 1,220 kilometers, the natural gas pipeline will run from Vyborg, Russia, to Greifswald, Germany, connecting the European mainland to Russia's vast gas supplies. The Nord Stream pipeline system is made up of two 1,224-kilometer-long pipelines that will be situated almost parallel to one another. A solid logistics chain, along with various technical innovations, are required in order to realize a project of this scale. Over 200,000 pipes will form the pipelines. They are made from an extremely hard, specially produced high tensile steel to withstand the pressure on both the inside and outside of the pipelines. Forming the pipes from the high tensile steel is a complex process, which makes accurate testing absolutely necessary. The 12-meter-long and up to 25-ton heavy pipes are welded together on the pipe-laying ships, which will lower the pipeline onto the seabed. The welds are especially vulnerable to cracks and leaks, and are therefore stringently tested with state-of-the-art technology to detect flaws. Flaws will be repaired, and the weld re-scanned to ensure it meets international quality standards.
Because of the high production of this barge and many barges that do pipelines, the welding has to be perfect from the start all the way through, or as near to it as we can get. This system will find out whether there's any flaws internal to the actual weld. So it doesn't matter whether it's on the internal or external surfaces or internal to the weld, we will be able to see it and then we can repair it before it goes into the water.
The qualified welders working aboard this floating factory oversee each of the pipe laying steps to ensure that welding procedures meet Nord Stream's and authority approved quality standards.
Of course, we're using electrical equipment here to complete the joints, and every joint is welded with a specific amperage and voltage, travel speed, and there is some science behind the whole topic of welding.
It's the experts behind every aspect of this project that will ensure both pipelines are completed on schedule. Completion of Line 1 is expected in April of 2011. Line 1 will be transporting gas by the end of 2011. Each line will have a transmission capacity of around 27.5 billion cubic meters a year. This is enough to satisfy the energy demand of more than 26 million households in Europe, making Nord Stream an important contributor to the security of Europe's future energy supply.